Next, I'm going to talk about prediction equations with multiple regression. And we'll want to consider the unstandardized coefficients, that version, and the standardized coefficients. We'll consider both of these versions, and for this, I'm going to remind you what the simple regression version was like, and then add, for comparison, the multiple regression version. So we'll start with the prediction equation for simple regression using unstandardized coefficients, and recall here we're predicting our outcome variable, which is exam grade, and we have our intercept plus the number of hours people studied times the slope for how many hours they studied. Right, so I'm going to actually record what these things are on the side here so we don't forget. So this is the predicted exam, predicted exam grade. A is the intercept. And recall, that's just the place where the regression line crosses over the vertical axis. So that's the intercept. I'll do x1 first. X1 is how many hours a person studied. And B1 is the slope for hours studied. All right, so if it's a positive B, the more hours you study, the more predicted, the higher the predicted exam grade. All right, and so when we talked about the simple regression previously, we said that we had some data and we got a prediction equation that looked like that. Right, so this means that somebody who doesn't study at all, if you put a zero in here, you'll predict their exam grade is a 20, which they will not pass my class with a 20. But usually people do study, right? And we'll say that somebody studies, we'll give an example. So this will, remember, this is given a data set that we produce this prediction equation. And then what we can do is when a new person shows up, we can plug in their value. So we'll say somebody shows up and this is, and we find that they study 10 hours a week. So what we can do is plug, for this person, we can plug their 10 hours in here, right? So we get y equals 20 plus 8 times 10. So here we have 80, 100. So if somebody studies 10 hours a week, we would predict they're going to get a perfect grade. So that's probably what you should be doing. And then I'll remind you how the standardized coefficient version of the prediction equation worked. Recall there what we did is we took our outcome variable and did a z-score transformation on it, took our predictor variable, did a z-score transformation on that, and then do the exact same prediction equation. So we're predicting the z-score for exam grade, and that's going to be the slope times the z-score for the number of hours you spend studying, right? This is the z-score for it. And remember, the cool thing about this, this isn't really used for actually predicting anybody's score because this is in z-score units. Remember, the cool thing here is this beta, the standardized regression coefficient, when you have simple regression, this is exactly the same as a regular old correlation coefficient. It's got a maximum of 1 when there's a perfect positive correlation, a minimum of negative 1 when there's a perfect negative correlation, and a 0 means they're unrelated. It's literally the exact, when you do simple regression, this beta is literally the exact same number you get if you just do a correlation. So they are interchangeable. So that's how the simple regression works. So let's move on to the new situation with multiple regression. Right, so our unstandardized prediction equation, we're still going to be predicting our exam grade, we're still going to have a place where the line, the predicted line, crosses over over the vertical axis. Although now it's going to be when all predictors have a value of zero, the number of hours studying is zero. And so we're going to bring over B1, X1, so those are the same. Now we're going to add the slope for our new variable and the place to put in the value for the new variable, right? And for this, we'll say, we'll keep everything the same, except we'll add X2, which will be the number of days the student attends class. And then B2 is going to be the slope for attendance. All right, and this almost certainly will be a positive slope, because the more you attend class, the more you expect the exam grade to increase. All right, and remember, whatever this actual slope is, if B2 equals 1, that means for each extra class you attend, your exam grade goes up by 1 point. And if B2 is 3, then for each extra class you attend, your exam grade goes up 3 points. Right? So it's just a regular old slope, but it's controlling for the other variable. All right, so let's say we have our data set, but instead of just having exam grade and hour studying, we also have attendance data. And so we do a multiple regression, right? We predict exam grade based on hour studying and attendance, and we get 20, let's say this changed to 6, because usually this slope does change. We'll say this is, we'll just say it's a simple 1. So this is the slope, B2 here. All right. And now to predict somebody's exam grade, we need not only their number of hours they study on average, but we also need their attendance. We'll say a person went to class 30 days, right? So now we can plug those numbers in. We have the predicted value is 20 plus 6 times X1. 6 times 10 plus 1 times X2 is 30. So we have 30 plus 60 plus 20 equals 110. Wow, that person did it pretty well. So this exam obviously doesn't have a cap at 100. Or maybe this person even got extra credit or something like that. It's also possible, though, to create a prediction equation based on one data set. And then if you're actually predicting values where the observed numbers that you put in, the observed numbers are the 30 and the 10. If these numbers weren't in the actual original data set, you can get predicted values for exam grade that are impossible values. So it's a little bit dangerous when you're doing multiple regression or simple regression. If you include observed values that weren't in your original data set, you can get results that don't make sense. But in this case, we'll just say that you predicted to actually get over 100%. Maybe there's extra credit or something like that on the exam. That's totally possible. So if you want to actually predict people's scores, you'd use these unstandardized coefficients. Or you can use standardized coefficients. And so for that, it'll start out the same. You have the predicted z-score for y. There's no intercept, because remember, for the standardized coefficients, this is always 0, so it drops out. The slope for number of hours you studied, the z-score for the number of hours you studied, then there'll be a new slope for attendance. These are z sub x1, z sub x sub 2. And again, you don't use this to actually predict scores, because predicting z-scores isn't all that useful. But these betas are super interesting to researchers. These are usually what researchers are interested in when they do multiple regression. So let's say we do this and we get .8 for hours studying and .4 for attendance. Now, these are kind of like correlation coefficients. They still have a maximum of +1, minimum of -1. except for the way that they're different is actually super important for interpretation. Because dot eight here is the correlation, basically, between our studying and exam grade, controlling for all the other predictors. And in this case, the other predictor is attendance. Right, and let's say that we do our statistical test and we get a p-value here of 0.001 and a p-value here of 0.01. Right, so these are both statistically significant. For both of them, we could decide that they're not zero, right? We could infer that there is a relationship. So what this would tell us is that the correlation between studying and exam grade is really strong, right? Couldn't be higher than one. So dot eight's a strong correlation, controlling for attendance. So that means even if people weren't attending class, really, right? You'd still think that studying would help their exam grade. Because this correlation controls for attendance. It excludes any effective attendance. So this is the relationship of studying and exam grade above and beyond attendance. And this is the correlation between attending class and exam grade above and beyond studying. Right, so regardless of how much you study, attending class improves your exam grade a little bit. Right? And regardless of how much you attend class, studying increases your exam grade, in this case, a lot. Right? And so these are controlling for the other variable. And now what we can do is we can directly compare these. Right? And dot eight is bigger than dot four. That means in this case, studying would have a bigger impact on your grade than attendance does. They both matter, but studying matters more. So because these are standardized, they're directly comparable, unlike here. Right? So these, you can't compare these because this is in units of days attending class. Right, and this is in units of hours studying. You can't compare six and one, but these are basically special correlations and you can directly compare them. And it tells you which has a stronger influence on your outcome variable, attendance or studying. And in this case, studying mattered more than attendance. So that's why researchers like these. And remember we talked about mediation and controlling for third variables. Both of them happen here, basically. So starting with the controlling for the third variable, we would interpret this such that studying predicts exam grade controlling for attendance, okay? Because it's significant. And attendance predicts exam grade controlling for studying because this is significant. Right? If this weren't significant, then attendance does not predict exam grade controlling for studying. Right, so that's how we use multiple regression to control for third variables. If they're still significant when you have the other variable in the prediction equation, if they're still significant, then that relationship holds between studying and exam grade, controlling for attendance. Right, but if it's non-significant, then that relationship doesn't hold, even if it did with a regular old simple correlation. Right now, this relationship has gone away. For mediation, it's actually kind of the reverse. So here, we have studying predicts exam grades, right? And we'll say all by itself, it predicted successfully. I will say that this correlation was, what did we have? Dot nine, right? So I didn't actually put that back up from before, but that's what we had here. So there's a very strong relationship between studying and the exam grade. And if we think that somehow attendance mediates this relationship, then what we do is we put attendance in a multiple regression with studying, both of them predicting exam grade. And if the relationship between studying and exam grade is completely due to attendance, this will drop from dot nine to something very small. So we'll say dot 0.02. And critically, it'll no longer be statistically significant. So that means that when you control for attendance, this relationship disappeared. The relationship we found with simple regression disappeared in multiple regression, controlling for the mediating variable. So that's what you would hope to find is, for studying to predict exam grade all by itself, but not anymore when you control for attendance. That's what mediation looks like with multiple regression.